Wow.
If I don't get this...
That's unfair. I swear you're in this video.
I was in the video.
That means nothing. 100%.
What did you mean with darkness?
Darkness, bro. Anything that's dark.
So first of all, there was charity and now there's this.
Welcome to the big Spurs quiz powered by HPE, the official IT networking partner of Tottenham Hotspur Football Club. Today, we have four players in teams of two going head to head. Let's meet the teams. Kulu, Brandon, and then obviously Danjuma, Sess. Good to have you all here. Confident or not so confident?
Confident, yeah, confident.
Thank you, that's what we like to hear. So I'm going to give you 1 minute between yourselves to come up with a team name, and that's how we're going to address you throughout this quiz. So when you're ready.
Do we need to write down?
Yes, please.
Don't copy our ID, you know?
Seriously, man. Well, I don't want to copy your ID.
That's it, man. Okay. Bangs.
Right, do you want to reveal your team names?
Oh, that's such a terrible name.
Showtime.
Showtime.
Danjess. Joss, how are we pronouncing that?
Danjess.
Danjess, and then what have we got over here?
It's Showtime.
Okay, just because Showtime, talk to me, why have we chosen this name?
Because we're Showtime, you know? that's what we do, that's how we live, you know?
Well, look at how cool he's got his arms like crossed over, so he means business. And then obviously, as I said, you guys, your name is very self-explanatory. Okay, are we ready to get into this HPE quiz? On the screen in front of you, we'll show some clips from the Spurs archive. So this first clip is taken from an old interview with Spurs legend, Michael Dawson. We have paused the clip before the end. We want you to guess what happens next.
Hopefully it'll be tomorrow night, there'll be another one to put on the board. But yeah, they're a good team.
Okay, I'll give you some time to think about what possibly could have happened next.
I don't even know. What?
Maybe to help you a little bit, think of Michael Dawson's personality.
I don't know, he makes a joke or something.
Yeah. In it.
Burst out laughing.
Okay.
You're saying he makes a joke.
Makes a joke. All right, let's play the clip and see what happens.
Hopefully it'll be tomorrow night, there'll be another one to put on the board. But yeah, they're a good team. What Jeez. The f- was that?
He's laughing. I don't see how he didn't get this right.
I'm going to have to give you a point.
Exactly, I have to give it. Yeah, for sure.
He
man.
Did
he
burst
laughing.
Out laughing. But what happened in that clip was one of the lights popped and it just made him jump.
Why are you not happy?
That's at least half a point.
Half enough. A point.
Yeah. But what does this say?
Burst out laughing.
And but what did you see?
We changed our, we changed our answer. Well. Burst out laughing.
Okay, we'll give you a half point. Half point. Okay, right, the next clip is taken from a 2013 Spurs game. Spurs are in the process of defending a counter-attack. What happens next? Okay, five, four...
No, no, wait, one second.
I don't know.
What have we got there?
Goal-saving tackle.
And on your board?
He dives.
Dives. Okay, let's reveal the answer to this clip. Jan Vertonghen there, pulling down Nicholas's shorts in a game.
Did they give penalty for this?
No, there was no penalty given.
What? Did they get away with this?
Right, so none of you got that answer correct. Let's go into the next clip. In this video from 2020, what is Sonny reacting to?
No!
If I don't get this...
That's unfair. I swear you're in this video.
I was in the video.
How is that fair if he's in the video?
What would have Sonny reacting that way?
Yeah, but bro, that's obvious.
Yeah, I know.
I don't think the question is that.
Like, what would really get him outraged like this?
I put reacting to a situation about the ref on FIFA.
Okay, and what have we got here?
Miss an open goal or a bad chance.
Okay, right, let's reveal what happens next. What is Sonny reacting to?
No offside, fouls or bookings.
No!
Change quickly, please.
Oh, it's the Arsenal team.
Well, yeah, you didn't get it right, but it was the Arsenal badge during No Rules FIFA. Okay, right, number four. This is about identifying who is in this picture. So, can we get the image on the screen, please? Who do you think these two players are?
They're two players?
So it's two players in your team.
Currently in our team?
Yeah.
What?
They're under a bit of a disguise. But if you look really carefully, I'm pretty sure you'll be able to get it. Showtime look ready and confident. Dan Jusses.
Okay, they've caught on.
Okay, is that a little fist pump there going like, yes?
Eric and Sonny.
Interesting, Eric and Sonny. Can we please reveal who these two mystery players are?
It's indeed
Sonny, but not Eric, it's Ben. Why did you all think it was Eric?
I think it's the beard, I think. Ben's beard now is a little bit longer, so.
Okay, I understand that. Why did you guys think it was Eric?
Same reason.
The beard. Wow, we really fooled you with that one, didn't we? Okay, right, last question from this round. Finish that headline. The new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium will have a something room.
This is when it was being built.
Yes. Okay, I'm going to give you 5 seconds.
I'm clueless with this. Wait, repeat the question, please. One more time.
The new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium will have a blank room. Are you guys quite confident with your answer?
I wouldn't say I'm confident, no, but we've got no other option.
Just guess at anything, man.
Distillery?
Secret.
You know what? I just want to give you a point for just that
impossible.
Oh my gosh, wow. To be fair, there aren't many secret rooms in the stadium, but the actual answer was a cheese room. The new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium will have a cheese room. And can we confirm, was that true? It was not true.
That wasn't true.
The British papers, it wasn't true. At the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium, HPE provide lightning fast Wi-Fi connectivity, and outside the stadium, they work to connect fans to the club wherever they may be. We created a list of questions for fans, accessible via QR codes, that we left around the concourse of the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium after the last few home games. To access the quiz, it's simple. Connect to the stadium Wi-Fi, scan the QR code on your mobile, and answer the questions.
Something you would do if the person sat next to you on a plane smelled really bad.
Something that would make you suspect your new house is haunted.
Something you wouldn't want to catch your neighbour doing.
Best topping on pizza.
I don't like to think about having a crush on Santa Claus, to be honest.
The Tottenham Hotspur player in the team that you most like to go on a night out with. I like this one.
So teams, we want you to guess the most common answers to each question that the fans on that video just answered. There will be 2 points for guessing the top answer, 1 point for guessing the second top answer, and half a point if you get the third top answer. So you can write your answers down on the boards in front of you. So the first question was, something you would do if a person sat next to you on a plane and they smelt really bad. I need 3 answers you think the fans said.
So what would you do if you sit on a plane next to someone who smells really bad?
Yeah.
Does it have to be in order or no?
No, just 3 answers and then we'll see if you're in line with what the Spurs fans have been saying. I like how serious everyone is taking this quiz. Really thinking about these answers. Showtime, would you want to read your 3 suggestions?
Ask them if they want some deodorant.
Okay.
Move away and just nothing.
Okay.
We put number 1 as move seat.
Uh-huh.
Number 2, cover their nose.
Uh-huh.
And number 3, like tell them they smell.
Both teams have done quite well on this. So 40% said suffer in silence.
That means nothing. 100%.
25% said try and master smell. And 10% said tell them that they smell.
What did you get? How many you get?
We got 2. Because if you cover your nose, you suffer in silence. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, that is true.
Thank you very much.
Are we going to give a point for that?
Yes, we are.
Yes.
Right, we've got from the audience here a yes. Oh, sorry about that, guys.
So first of all, there was charity and now there's this.
It's unbelievable.
If you cover your nose, you suffer in silence.
Okay. Play.
All right, let's go into number 2. Now you get the feel for it.
You see what I did?
Okay, question number 2. Something that would make you suspect your new house is haunted.
Don't put this as one though. Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Creaking doors, floors, things being moved, and things turning on by themselves. And what have you got there?
We put number one as strange noises.
Uh-huh.
Number two, movement.
Thank you.
Number three, weird voices.
3 out of 3.
Okay, so 15% was moving furniture and objects.
So and movement.
Yeah,
movement.
Well done. And you guys had
things being moved.
Exactly. The next one was 25% of our fans thought mysterious voices.
Thank you.
Well done. And the third one was seeing a ghost. Question number three, something you wouldn't want to catch your neighbor doing.
Oh my dear.
Yeah.
I can think of anything.
Do you want to write that?
Yeah, go on. Neighbor or neighbors?
Something you wouldn't catch your neighbor doing. Okay, do you want to read on what's on your board?
So, number one, being intimate.
Okay.
Number two, arguing.
Okay.
And number three, nude.
Nobody wants to see that. What have you got on there?
Yes! Yes!
Criminal activity.
Yeah.
Making noise.
Yeah.
And make a love.
So, okay. This is what they said. So at number one, 45% of Spurs fans didn't want to catch their neighbour supporting Arsenal.
Oh my.
Oh, of course.
We're so damn stupid.
25% said they wouldn't want to catch their neighbour stealing their things.
It's criminal activity.
And yeah, that is, yeah, well done. And the third one with 15% was spying on you without your knowledge. Number four, something you would see outside that would make you want to stay inside. If you can reveal your board, please, Brandon. So what have you got there?
Raining, bad weather.
Yep.
Arsenal fans or celebrations.
Uh-huh.
And darkness.
Okay.
We've got anything related to Arsenal, the rain, the storm.
So 50% said they don't want to see Arsenal players or fans, so well done. The next one was bad or dangerous weather. So yeah, well done. And then the last one was zombies, which technically I'm going to say is darkness. I'm going to give it. It is darkness.
It's darkness, bro.
You saw a zombie coming in right now. That's you're running, you're legging it out of here. So I'm going to give that to you. Yeah.
So they got 3 out of 3?
Yeah, I'm going to give it to them, yeah.
What did you mean with darkness?
Darkness, bro. Anything that's dark. Hey, Dan, don't hate the players, hate the game, bro.
Right, number six. Best topping on pizza.
Oh. Go on, then.
Yeah, one of those.
Three.
Which
one? You choose, bro.
Number three.
Yeah, so three.
Okay, let's reveal some of your boards. Reveal these answers. Pepperoni, cheese, and ham. What have we got in here?
Pepperoni, meat, feast, pineapple.
Okay, so they said pepperoni, so well done. You'll get points for that. Anything but pineapple, and ham and pineapple.
So pineapple's not?
No.
Really, you should be getting -1 for
pineapple. Exactly.
But that's another question.
If someone had a crush on Santa Claus, they might leave this out for him instead of cookies.
What is...
Pens down, please. Showtime, can you reveal your board? What have you got on there?
Tottenham shirt. Beer and a love letter.
Okay, Dan Jassess, what have you got on there?
Sweets,
yep.
Roses, uh-huh. Chocolate.
Okay, so these were the answers. Tastier food, a love letter, and themselves. I'm actually very impressed at how you even got that.
It's all well Becky, done. That's all Becky.
Yeah, okay, yeah, you got to clap that. We do have to clap that. I'm impressed by that, well done. Okay, and the last one of this round. The Tottenham Hotspur player in the team that you'd most like to go on a night out with?
According to the fence.
Let's see the answers. Dan Jassess, if you want to go first.
Richie, Sonny, Harry.
Okay.
Sonny, Harry, Kuti.
Well done. You guys got all three correct. It was Richarlison, Harry Kane, and Heung-min Son. Let's get into the next round. First question. This season, someone in the team became Tottenham Hotspur's most followed current player on Instagram. Name that player.
It's easy.
Okay, we've got Easy over here. Mm-hmm.
I think so, bro, but I don't know.
Should have gone with Mike.
I don't think he's right, you know.
It's too late now to change your answer. Okay, right, turn your boards round and let's see who's got this first answer correct. None of you have got it right, but I'm going to give you a clue. Think World Cup.
Told you.
No, that's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now you get it. Now it's, yeah. Oh, but okay. You know, just for when you... Yes, well done. What did you put? Wow. Let's see what you put on that board then. Let's see. Wow. We've got Romero on this board.
That was silly from us.
Yeah, man, that was silly.
They said it. Question number two. Hugo Lloris announced his retirement from international football this year. But what year did he make his senior debut for France? Okay, I'm going to have to give you 5 seconds and I need an answer on the board. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Please reveal your answers.
Oh, that's mad.
Is that, what is that, a 9 or a 4?
It's a 4.
It's a 4.
What did you put, 4?
Don't worry, no, it's got a 9.
There's a 9. So neither of you have got this answer correct, but the closest...
That's us.
With Showtime, Hugo made his debut in 2008. So well done. It was close. Wasn't the right answer, but close. Question number three. This year, Harry Kane broke Jimmy Greaves' record to become Tottenham Hotspur's all-time top goal scorer. But who was Harry's first senior Spurs goal against?
Look, Mr. Tottenham here.
Who?
You!
I don't know what this is.
Well, we've already got stress over there from Cess. We've got some confidence over here from Showtime.
Is it his first goal, yeah?
Yes. Against who? And Cess?
Shamrock Rovers.
You both got it correct. Well done. Well done.
Knowledge.
Okay, right. Question number four. This year, Heung-min Son became the 8th Spurs player to join the Premier League 100 club. Can you name the other 7? The team with the most correct names wins the point.
Wait, was you in the canteen when we did this like last week?
No.
Brandon is drawing on from previous experiences there.
Oh no, he already counts, yeah.
Now, just before you reveal your answers, Brandon, Showtime, I want to come to you. You said that you spoke about this last week. Whereabouts did you do this?
In the canteen at lunch. It was me, Jaff and Skippy.
What was the purpose of doing this?
Just for some entertainment at lunchtime. We were trying to get them all in order.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, if I haven't got these, I think I'll be getting some stick in the changing room.
Cess, if you read out your answer, please.
So we got Kane.
Yep.
Defoe.
Mm-hmm.
Sheringham.
Okay.
And Bale.
Harry Kane.
Mm-hmm.
Teddy Sheringham.
Mm-hmm.
Pierre Crouch. Darren Bent. Robbie Keane.
Guys, that knowledge that you had, or that game that you're playing with Jaff, well done. It definitely helped because you did excellently well. The 7 names you could have had were Kane, Sheringham, Ferdinand, Defoe, Keane, Bent and Crouch. So, I mean, you guys have clearly taken that question. Well done. Question number 5. In February, Oliver Skip scored his first senior goal for Spurs, but it was his second goal of his professional career. For which club did he score his first senior goal? And I'm not even going to lie, the quickness you all just took the lids off meant that we all know the answer. Okay, you can all say the answer at the same time.
Norwich.
Well done. You didn't say it, but Norwich. Well done. Right, it's getting heated, it's getting good. This is your last round, the big Spurs quiz powered by HPE. 2 of the cards have lies written on them and 1 is blank. You have 2 minutes to add your own true story to the list and then you'll read out all stories and then each team has to guess which is the truth.
What's the story you've been through?
So I guess this round is about your acting skills. How believable can you make this? Because you guys were ready first. Can you please read out all 3 stories and then we'll have to guess which is the truth and what 2 are the lies. So when you're ready.
A few years ago, I bought a restaurant, but I failed very quickly and I had to shut it down. That's me. A few years ago, I got run over by a car. Cess, I own a pet goat. Cess.
And we get to ask questions.
Yeah, you can ask questions.
Did you say, Cess, you want a pet?
No, I own a pet goat.
What's the goat's name?
Jerry.
Did you name it or was it like named when you got it?
It was already named.
Where'd you get it from?
Someone gave it to me.
What kind of restaurant was it, Dan?
Chinese restaurant.
And what was the other? What was your other one? You got ran over by a car.
Yeah.
Was that you or Cess?
Cess.
When was that, Cess?
A few years ago.
Where was you?
I was outside my house.
You know, tell us the story of how it happened or?
No, I don't want to be honest with you.
Right, Showtime. Would you like to guess which one is the truth? And which 2 are lies?
So the restaurants lie, and you didn't have a dog.
A dog.
A goat. You said dog or goat. Goat, yeah?
So which one do you think is true?
That you was hit by a car.
Would you like to tell us which one is the truth and which one is the lie?
No, they got it right. What?
The truth is, a few years ago, you did get hit by a car. Wow. Guys, are you ready for your ones?
Yep.
Okay.
I have secretly been learning magic. I am very good.
When I was younger, I wanted to be a marine biologist.
And your last one.
When Deki was younger, he didn't want to be a footballer, he wanted to be a librarian.
Yeah, that's it, man.
Okay. Oh, you kind of responded quite quickly.
It's the last one.
Do you want to ask some questions?
I know it's the last one.
Do you want to ask some questions?
I forgot. What was the last one, sir?
When Deki was younger, he didn't want to be a footballer, he wanted to be a librarian.
A librarian? So you're interested in book? Ah, I know it's the last one. Do you not know?
What was the last one?
He reads a lot, you know, I just realized. It is the last one.
It's the last one.
We need to answer. Yep.
Okay, so what are you saying is the truth?
Librarian.
Okay. Do you guys want to tell us which is the lie and which is the truth?
When I was younger, I wanted to be a marine biologist.
Brandon!
Is that really
true? Actually...
Wow! Where did that come from, like?
When I was younger, I used to love sharks. I used to have, like, an obsession with sharks.
Have you ever done, like, swam with sharks or anything like that in the game?
Yeah, I have, actually, when I was younger. Whale sharks.
Hey, sick!
Yeah.
Well, that is a fun fact that we will learn about Brandon Austin today. What? Okay, well done. That is the end of the quiz. It came down to the wire with the teams, actually. It was very, very close. The winner of the Big Spurs quiz is Showtime.
Sit down, bro.
It is Showtime. Wow, you guys got very confident. It was very close, though. Well done, Showtime. Your knowledge was outstanding. And to be fair, Dan Giuseppe, your knowledge was also very, very good as well. This has been the Big Spurs quiz powered by HPE. Congratulations to our winners. See you next time. Well done.